Jam 103.6.
It's all about Jamma. He's in the building.
Yeah, buddy.
Obviously, come on.
How you doing?
It's nice.
I'm all right, actually. It's a good day.
It is a good day.
It was meant to be very hot today, but it was a bit cloudy, but still, it's been a good day. Enjoying life.
Were you prepared for the sun? You're a sun guy. Like, last time I saw you, you was wearing some, like, Caribbean twist jumper.
Yeah. You know what? To be honest, like, I was doing some stuff before this. Like, it wasn't a swag day for me. You get me? Like, I was doing some bits and bobs, so I didn't really have my swag turn up today. Okay. But, yeah, normally I'll be outrageous. You get me?
Well, you look good. I'm admiring your lovely tattoo on your arm. You're working on a new work of art.
Yeah, I'm working on the second arm, so I'm just doing that. You get me? Shouts to Tat City. That's where I get my ink at. You get me? So I've been working on a lot of ink recently. I'm trying to just get my whole bodysuit finished by 2014, so I'm looking like a human amplifier.
Oh, Jams, man. I don't like it when people do that,
you
man.
You just say bodysuit.
Why have you got a deadline to do all your tats up? Like?
Because basically, I don't want to keep doing it. Like, I just want to get it done, so I've got it. That's it.
Are you covering your whole body?
Yeah.
No way.
But don't you think, don't you think with, like, tattoos, it's like, it comes with, like, you know, stuff you experience in
life?
I've
experienced a lot. I've lived for 31
man,
years.
Yeah.
And I've been doing music for 10 years.
Life begins at 40.
Huh?
Life begins at 40.
Yeah, so but my life started at 18, to be honest.
Alright.
You get me?
Well, fair enough. Like,
well, we're talking about a new life.
Yeah.
Album, Living the Dream.
No, you're... The Living Dream.
Is it The Living Dream?
He's buzzing it.
The Living Dream, 1st of July.
I read the
words back to front.
No, he's buzzing it.
I'm confused. I'm like, what did I read?
Nah, he's barring it.
Okay.
But obviously, I've only just clocked. I've clocked the pause now, so I'm onto it. So the band's all right.
Wait, I'm confused. Yeah.
What is the album name?
Nah, the album's called Living the Dream.
See, I knew I was right.
Nah.
Yeah, fam.
I thought it was The Living Dream.
No, see?
I thought it was actually The Living Dream.
I felt like a failure of a presenter. I was like, oh my God.
You was on point.
To be fair, I'm dyslexic, innit? To be fair.
That makes sense. You explained a lot to me right now.
Yeah, okay. We can forgive you for that, man.
Thank you.
You're on a real calm vibe right now. I like it. However, when we do look at the Twitter, when we do look at, like, Jammer's
Decline.
Literally, like, today,
no,
of
do you know
all
what it
days.
Is? Can I just
like,
touch on that as well?
Yeah.
Because obviously, right, I'm a very comical person. I'm a very, like, outgoing. I've got a lot of banter. Obviously, I've done the Merkle Man thing. I've done, like, Decline. I've done other things that are comical. And obviously, people will see that and think, you don't have no substance or depth to you. Do you know what I mean? And they don't think that you've got anything in your brain. So, like, that's what this album's about. That's what I'm saying. That's why I'm talking to you like this, so you can understand. And everybody that hears this interview and goes to check out the album understands where I'm coming from with it.
Yeah. Well, Decline seems to be... It was your kind of launch of letting everyone know the album's coming. You're going to be real about it. You're going to be serious. But, of course, everyone automatically went, wait, Decline? That's the thing you did with, like, that's the banter with Snakey Man. So it's like, you know, I feel like you've got two things going on right now. You're saying, yeah, I'm serious on this and that. But at the same time, everyone sees the indirect in Decline.
Do you know what it is? This is what it is. Everybody don't understand. My whole career, other than my producing for what I've done for other people, I mean, me as a person, solo, comes from being I'm a club murkers. I murk the clubs. That's my thing, innit? So Decline, just my club tune. Now, so when people say, oh my God, have you seen Jamma? He's mad in the club. So that's my thing for the clubs. But for the people that want to listen and take in a good album, that's the other tracks on the album. There's a lot of other music to listen to on there.
Can you define what Living the Dream is? Like, what is Living the Dream to Jamma?
For me, like, to be honest, man, like, my life, what I do, I go out, like, I just wake up in the morning, I just turn my music, my laptop on, I listen to music, my friend might call me, I'm my own boss, I do what I want, I go studio, I make a song that feels good to me, something I enjoy doing, I might go and link up with people that I never dreamed of even being in the same room with, like Puff Daddy, and go and pouring champagne over my head, and I'm going around meeting all these people, I'm going to touring these places
that's crazy.
This is my life, so even though I might not be where I want to be finally, but to be doing what I'm doing now, like when I used to go to like cool school and that, and look at Shabba and Skibber on stage and think, wow, how did they get on the stage? Like, how did you get around there? Like, how, this is mad. Like, oh, I want to be him. Like, I just want to be him. And then obviously down the line, we are the guys that are murking it. And then guys that I was looking at on the stage are coming up to me saying, I'm the guy.
And just to touch on that, I know a lot of people are talking about Jay-Z's album coming out, and these pictures have been out with, like, you know, these top producers, including Rick Rubin, who I had to do some research and ask who the hell is this guy with this big beard.
He's the guy.
And I saw a tweet from you saying that a couple of years back, Rick Rubin was listening to your music.
That's so awesome.
How did that come about?
I love that.
That was, I was working with Vice Magazine. Yeah. I don't know if you know them. They were doing a lot of stuff. They were the first people to, like, take me to Europe and take me to America and take me over those places, because they got that whole trendy skateboard community going on, like from Shoreditch to New York to LA, you get what I'm saying? So that is how the breakthrough is. Like, when Little B comes over here, he goes to Shoreditch, because those are the type of people that are first hearing about Little B, so they'll bring me over there to the trendy lot of Americans that know about the UK guys, so you know what I mean? So through the link with James J. Medina, which was my photographer at the time, but he was a photographer, but he just used to love my music. He was just into my stuff. So all the little people that he would meet on his travels around the world working for the magazine, he would bring me. Like, he took me on, he took me to Castaba Jack. Castaba Jack painted 11 meters tall painting of me in opposite Eiffel Tower for the Castaba Jack range. He's the guy that originally designed Iceberg History, and he launched his new range, and he got like us,
hashtag
like me and a few of my
dream.
To come. And this was this is all that, that's old news. Like, we're doing stuff now. Like, I can't even tell you stuff what's going on, like what we got in the pipeline. Like, it's scary, you know what I'm saying?
I mean,
I'm doing mental stuff.
Wow.
But I mean, you guys have always done crazy things. I mean, the whole of you, BBK, Boy Better Know. I mean, all right, one thing I want to ask you about is these BBK, the Boy Better Know SIM cards. I've never called anyone and said you've reached the Boy Better Know voice. Like, what's going on with Boy Better Know SIM cards?
It's a unique thing, and it's for our fans. We've got people that follow us do everything.
Your followers are so, like, strong. It's serious.
Like, if you ain't got it, we don't care.
No, but what's the price plan? I'm trying to. What is they bringing?
No, we don't want you to have it.
Oh, okay. It's all right. Of course, same. All right.
You can't. No, do your thing.
Declined.
Declined. Decline the BBK credit check. You know, decline. Big D's.
Get me. Right. No, because you've already tried to buzz it a couple times.
I wasn't trying to buzz it, bro. I told you, I was dyslexic.
I tell you what. I clocked. Seconds in, because I've watched the interviews before and I knew you're the buzzers, innit? But today I've just come on, I've been doing stuff, I forgot about the I didn't pre it, innit? I've got to get here, we was late, I rushed, get me?
I'm not messing with you because I've seen how you're the buzzers, Snakey,
but
man.
Now I'm on to you.
I'm good,
I now look a bit like Arnold Snakey, man, but it's not me, like, it's not me that got declined.
Well, you brought me back to it, look. All right. Arnold, Snakey Man, to those who aren't aware of his, like, acting career and that. He's out in Hollywood, he likes to say, working with Reese Witherspoon, doing his thing. We would have thought he would have been way past this whole decline thing. Me personally, Arnold, I love you. But this tweet this morning was a bit unnecessary. So he tweeted a pic like, oh, I just bought my mom a Benz, a Mercedes. She's always wanted it and deserved the best, and now I can finally give her the best. And then he said, ha ha ha, a beggar man tell me about decline, please. And then he said, hashtag karma. And then he went on to say, oh, it was a dead joke. It was never true about decline. And then he said, F off, snitchy, mate, on the incline. I feel like he just brought it up again.
Yeah, yeah, he did.
Like, for me, no reason. So what was your reaction to that?
Because obviously, in his heart, he must still be upset about it. So what we want to see is the receipt for your mum's whip. We want to see the whip.
Yeah. No, I'm leaving.
And we want to see your mum saying, he bought me a whip. Until then, it's decline.
Decline.
Because, obviously, you could just come on Twitter and say you bought your mama with her. Bruh,
oh, no.
Come to the bank with man, innit? Don't go on your Twitter chatting pop about you bought your mama toy car.
So what are you saying? Jammer's calm, yeah?
I'm calm. Now, obviously, it's not that, but obviously, I've had to phone him today. Me and like, yeah. The thing is,
I'm glad you did that. I'm really glad that you spoke to him personally.
I work in a phone shop. I'm going to do that to all my customers when they fail the credit check.
Like, you know how many people at work text me people from work, like when they're working and people get declined, they message me. Like, I wanted to shout in their face so much. Like, they tweet my jam. I wanted to shout it so loud.
I'm going to do that tomorrow, 100%.
Some people even say they did it, yeah, but I don't know if I believe them.
Nah, I'm actually going to record myself doing it. Watch.
No, don't do it, B.
I'm cool, man. I'm allowed to get away with stuff like that.
Skepta's trying to FaceTime us. We should add Wi-Fi and bought him.
Skepta.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
I'm finally blown up in this game. Hey, 100 likes on Instagram tonight.
I'm done.
We know about Skepta trying to FaceTime, man.
He's not calling you, B.
It doesn't matter. I'm here. He's FaceTiming me. Pause. I'm violence. You get me?
Mental.
But seriously, like going back to the call with Snakey, how did it go? I really want to know. Was it
Look,
peaceful?
I just wanted to have a middle ground with a minute because like we've been doing this thing. Obviously, we've got a lot of like hype around it or whatever. You know, like my thing is. Like you did get declined, like you still owe me the money.
Oh, God.
And
how
I don't even
it?
Want the money back. It's like a couple hundred quid or whatever, it's a couple bottles of champs. We don't even want the money back, innit? Like, but don't keep trying to say that it didn't happen, because it did. And all right, cool. We know that you have to defend yourself and say that, because that's what you have to say, yeah. Innit? Really? Not you don't have to say that. That's the truth. What you should have really done. He said, oh, yeah, my card declined. What? It happens. Mm. Keep it moving. And it wouldn't even have been such a big thing.
Yeah.
It's because you tried to lie and make a documentary and all this stuff. You go on to lie and there's a documentary with black background and the music comes in. Like, and he's like talking about it, bruv. It's serious, bruv.
Are you serious?
A deeper documentary where he's talking about it. And you know that when someone's lying, innit, they blink. And it... That's what he's doing all through the interview. And, like, and you know, like when you was there, yeah, and yeah. Someone's lying and you're looking at them, you're like, are you really looking into the camera, lying and blinking?
Bareface.
But yeah, like, it's all good, innit? Like, he said to me he's going to come to the birthday and celebrate and he's going to bring his card and buy bottles this time and not decline, innit? So if you do that, it's all good, innit? You come, do your thing, it's all love. But like I said, don't lie on Twitter, innit?
Congratulations with Lord of the Mics, because
yeah, that's
Lord of the Mics is, when it's all said and done, no matter what you achieve, you can say that you are someone who has documented and also pushed some of, like, I was on another popular urban blog, no names, and they always do like a Flashback Friday thing, and that was the other blog, right? But they did this, they showed like an old school Lord of the Mics, the classic Kano versus Wiley, and I was thinking, yeah. These lot are rich now, you know, and you was doing that and yeah, you know pushing yeah. That before that even
yeah,
happened
yeah, yeah.
Do you know what I mean? It's crazy,
because
man.
I believed in Kano, like, come on, I put Kano on his first records. Like, I put him in the studio. Do you know what I mean? I put him there. I released his first records because I knew this guy was going to be big, and that's what it's about.
You still have a relationship?
Who? What?
You and Kano.
What?
Like, no, come on, bro. Like, do you lot still talk? Are you lot still?
Oh,
like...
do we still speak now?
You're not trying to buzz it.
No, do you know what? We don't really speak that much now because, to be honest, yeah, when I was making that album, basically, yeah. I don't want to say anything because me and Da Vinci are cool now and everything, but the manager I had, me and Da Vinci's here at the same manager.
Yeah.
And basically, they used to just steal my sound and my music. Yeah. And all, if you notice, a lot of that stuff, what Kano was making sounds like the stuff that he made with me, but when they made the album, they went and shifted the deal and went and remade the stuff with Mikey J and with them guys. Yeah. And like, that was basically, you stole my whole thing that I've built and run off. So, cool. Innit? That's why for a little while I stopped making music. Yeah. I just stopped making beats. I just said, you know what, I got the MC and thing that I'm doing now, because man, I just teething my stuff, innit?
Yeah.
Like, well, it's definitely time to celebrate, and you're going to be doing that.
Yeah, on the 29th of June, right?
29th of June, man.
9 days.
Yeah, 9 days is going to be mad. Like, come on, man. Last year it was the like most talked about party of last year. Do you get what I'm saying? This year it's going to be even more epic.
Wait, am I dyslexic? How's the 29th of June in 9 days?
Wait, sorry, I just realised that's 10.
That's 11 days.
Oh, sorry, I did it wrong. That was my bad.
You're buzzing it.
I'm sorry.
29th of June.
I can't count.
O2 Arena.
And Aston, you wasn't going to say nothing.
What?
And you had a timing, man.
Everyone backed it. Everyone just supported.
You know, I actually had to count on my feet. I was like, nah.
I can't believe it.
So what? So 29th of June, O2 Arena.
Yeah, Aston almost made us not be here today as well.
Because you can count, or
basically.
Sure,
the timing guy,
all right.
And he didn't get the times right.
Don't worry, we'll work on it, Aston. It's fine.
But yeah, 29th of June.
But make sure you're down there. 29th of June. Trust me, it's going to be mental. Come down there, celebrate with everyone. Everyone's going to be down there. You get me? I don't need to like drop names, but trust me, all the no, people.
Drop names.
I want to
know who
I know you're going to have like other people. You might have someone else covering it, but I'm pretty sure you're going to get Link Up TV to come down. And I'm pretty sure
you're not coming.
Oh. Oh, okay.
But obviously,
he's not coming.
Yeah, he's not coming. He's you're there.
Thanks, Shower.
But you know, that's how it usually goes. Them lot get
stop
in,
touching.
And I have to
stop,
pay.
Stop
oh,
touching.
All right, cool. You know, the YouTube comments are going to run away with this one.
It's just Jammer and Ramel London.
Yeah,
right,
like, you know, I like him. We're good. But sometimes you just got to breathe.
Oh, okay. Sorry. Thank you.
Oh,
you know
no.
what? It's Jammer though, so he's a legend in the game. So
exactly,
I,
you have to allow
it. You gotta take that one.
Now, like I said, I'm never gonna be watching back this documentary thinking, why did I let him buzz me all through this? And I didn't clock. Because, like, if I was on an off day, get me, if I had a little cigarette before I came, yeah, a little,
Yeah.
I might have let you buzz me.
No, man, you're moving parole.
I'm proud of you. You got him back. That was good. I like that.
Jammer has stood up for all you UK artists out there, yeah. But don't. But you're not Jammer. Don't think you're coming.
I see a couple men getting buzzed, and you didn't clock the buzz.
Warning.
Trust me,
warning. If you haven't been doing this for 10 years plus, don't think you could do that, though. No, you can't do it again.
No, but I see it was a bit shaky with, like, Jay Spade's a couple.
Bobby's hedge, bro. He's right there. Like, look at the door. You know where the door is, man.
Be money will be finished.
You're saying, well, you're not shook, man.
No, I'm scared. Boys do know. Boys have been knowing for years. I know. BBK.
I'm from down the road from J&M. Like, obviously.
I know. All East London people are crazy.
He's letting you know, boy. The backup's local.
I'm scared of anyone with dreadlocks. I'm over there.
I swear, yes.
Well, do you know what? We'll end it there. Thank you so much, Jammer, for joining us.
Yeah, but you ain't told them when my album's out, though.
Yeah, I did. 1st of July.
You did.
Living the dream.
Talking to you, blood.
Sorry.
Man's not talking to you, blood. Listen, the album, 1st of July. Yeah, make sure you go get that Living the Dream. Pre-order now on iTunes if you want to support the cause. Go and get it on data release if you're one of those tight. You get me? Pagans. But, I'll let you say your piece. You got anything else to say?
No, like, it's really nice to meet you. I've met you. I've seen you perform once at Cargo. I'm going to sound like I'm just a beg, but... You know, I rate you.
No, I rate you as well. You're doing your thing.
He loves
you're
you, Jammer.
You're like a side man on the show.
Yeah. Now, you saw what he did when Skepta was FaceTiming. He loves you.
I rate
I'm
you,
a fan, though.
He's enthusiastic and
he knows
things.
Yes.
The questions
he's
that
educated.
He's asking, he's educated. So in your dyslexic brain somewhere, you do have a brain.
You know what? I'll just be real with you. A lot of UK people don't, especially black people, don't like to show that they're fans. I'm a fan.
Yeah.
So
good
I'll keep it 100.
You.
I'm a fan.
And I'm a fan of the show as well. That's why I come on.
Thank you.
So it's all good.
Thank you.
Circle.
Oh yes, this is Tuesday Night Link Up. We've got Jammer shutting it down as always. Thank you.
Woo!
I show love. Okay, stay with us. This is Bang.